American Cooling and Heating has the right team and the right stuff. Call anytime. Even weekend service at no extra charge. Who does that anymore? American Cooling and Heating. They'll treat you like family. Well, Mayor Greg Cromer was with officials of Louisiana Economic Development and others getting recognized for Slidell's new plan. It's actually a revised plan for economic development. And without further ado, tell us what's in it.
We're highlighting the workforce we have, the education system we got in this corridor, and the infrastructure, that being east-west, north-south roads, east-west and north railways. We can't say south because you can't go much further south than we are, but we have access into New Orleans and the port system. We got deep water access in St. Tammany Parish in New Orleans and in Hancock County at the port of Hancock County. So we're pulling all of those resources together to assure that we've got sites that are located within our community that are ready for development, that people can come in, they can get permitted, they can get a business up and running and get moving.
I looked over the plan briefly and it struck me that you quoted 90,000 is the population of the Slidell area. That's a lot of people.
Yeah, those numbers came out before the last census tract. We're probably in the four zip codes that call themselves Slidell, 704-5859 and 6061. There's 108,000 people in those four zip codes currently. There's about 30,000 people in the city limits proper, but when we do projects and we make decisions about our community, we're thinking of 100,000 people and not just the 30,000 that are in the city limits.
Well, what kinds of industries are you thinking about that Slidell would attract?
We're looking at light manufacturing industries that would assemble widgets, components, seats, seat belts. We're looking at things that we could do with the aerospace business and for the Airbus people over in Mobile, assemble little components, wheels, wiring harnesses, anything like that, as well as the distribution logistics systems, with the infrastructure we've got going every direction away from here. In the space that we have available for development of large-scale buildings, we could do significant warehousing projects, moving cargo off of boats and into inland infrastructure.
Well, good segue to Amazon.com. How is that project coming? Are they still set to open next year?
Yes. The last I heard from Amazon was that first quarter of 23, they should be on target to open up and get things moving in our community.
That'll be at the old mall.
That's in the Primo Development Center over there. They've got a brand new building built to 140,000 square feet, landscaped. They're working on putting their logistical equipment, their conveyors and what have you, in the building now.
So work's actually begun.
Building's complete, ready to roll, yes. Their problem is getting in the conveyors, the robots, the things that are going to move product around in the building.
Well, nothing like success, and you'd have to think getting one of the biggest corporations on earth is not a small thing for Slidell.
Yeah, we're very fortunate to have Amazon make the commitment to our community. It's an end-of-the-line center. It's not one of their big mega centers, but it's 140,000 square feet under one roof. It's a big building.
Well, also, what about the old Target building that was sold for $2 million last year? Nobody knows to whom, but presumably it's going to be something.
I wish I could answer that question. I've reached out to the realtors that sold the building to see if they'll give me some insight as to who's doing what and what their plans are, but they don't even respond to my calls here lately. So I have no idea what's going there. It's a big, beautiful building that could be a really neat space for entertainment, shopping, whatever you would want to do in there.
What about the sales tax receipts here? Have they held up?
Oh, gosh, yeah. The last fiscal year, which ended for us in end of June, we're up almost 11% year over year.
And last year they were up.
Yes. And last year they were up too. We had several months in this previous year. In 1 month we were up 26% over the same month the year before. We only had two down months in the past 4 years.
Do you see the recession on the horizon that the national media has talked so much about? Because it's hard to really see it in these numbers.
It's hard to say. I know at some point there's going to be somewhat of a pullback in the economy in our area, but when that will occur, if I had that crystal ball, I'd be investing a lot more money in the stock market.
People want to know about retail. They want to know about restaurants. They want to know about fun stuff. which is also part of economic development. What kinds of nibbles are you getting there?
We've talked to some of the bigger companies that do these bowling alley, laser tag, game type facilities, sports bar combination type things. Still trying to find the right fit for space and the right group to invest.
You must just be delighted, though, at the Fremo project, how that shopping center has taken off beyond expectations.
Sure, absolutely. You know, I think they're 80-85% capacity now. They've got plans to do some more development, put some more buildings in, but they're not doing anything until they've got people that are ready to move in.
Well, in the meantime, you announced you're running for parish president next year. Congratulations.
Thank you.
What made you move in that direction?
You know, it's I've just had an enormous number of people in our community in St. Tammany Parish come to me and ask me if I would consider doing taking that step. And there seems to be a lot of buzz about what we've done in the side area in our city. I guess the sentiment is that people feel like that I can take that to a greater level, and I believe we can.
Well, let's see, a popular mayor with a good record in his city running for parish president. Sounds like a familiar scenario.
Yeah, I think it's happened once before. Yes, sir.
What kind of a campaign do you imagine?
Oh, you know, we're 15 months out. We're just getting started. It won't be cheap, but when we campaign, we're going to talk about Greg Cromer and what we've accomplished, not about any predecessor.
Well, that said, are there some things you can tell us that you would like to add in parish government?
To add to parish government?
Or do better?
We haven't really worked a platform yet, but there's several things that I'm thinking about doing. One is just to have an overall government summit, if you will, that will bring in the chief judge, bring in the coroner, the DA, the sheriff, St. Tammany Parish President, sit down around a table, and when we walk out, shaking hands and working together rather than working separately and pointing fingers at each other. We've got to figure out a way, at the very least, that we can get along for the constituents and the general public to have any confidence in what we do.
Some of those guys you mentioned are suing each other now.
You said it, I didn't, I wasn't going to go there, but I you know, that's part of it. People see what's happening at those levels, and they lose confidence very quickly in our ability to manage and govern and move our community in the right direction.
What else do you want to share with us?
Oh, I'm just excited as I can be to get this recertification done. There's so many opportunities that are offshoots from the space program, from the logistics and distribution opportunities that we can put in here with warehousing and distribution. We can't lose any more projects of those types to anybody else around us.
Especially with the junction of three interstates, which is very rare.
Yes. We're one of the few places in the country that you can say that. And if we don't capitalize on that, shame on us.
Great news. There's someone you can call for fast, reliable service on your air conditioning. American Cooling and Heating. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Friendly people who are experts at what they do. 25 years in business with lots of satisfied customers, old-fashioned service, plus the wherewithal to get the job done right. American Cooling and Heating,